Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let me thank God for His grace over every one of us throughout the year 2020. We thank God for the way He has preserved us. We thank God for His mighty power over our lives. Beloved, wherever you are, I pray that the Holy Spirit of God will speak to you as we bring up now this New Year's message. Wherever you are, I want to bow your heads and let us pray. Our God, today our hearts are filled with joy because you are the God who has preserved us. Our Lord and our Father, as we listen to your words today, come and speak to us.
Amen.
Come and empower our lives and our destiny through your word today.
Amen.
Help us to be what you want us to be.
Amen.
Help us, oh Lord, to please you in our own lives.
Amen.
Thank you, Heavenly Father.
Thank you,
for we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Please, I want you to open your Bibles with me to the book of Psalm 32. We are reading from Psalm 32. We are also going to read from Psalm 34. So open your Bibles with me to Psalm 32. I'm going to read verse 8. Psalm 32. I'm reading verse 8. It says, I will instruct thee and teach thee in the way which thou shalt go. I will guide thee with my eye. Let's move over to Psalm 34. As I read from verse 3 to verse 5. Psalm 34, from verse 3 to verse 5. Beloved, it says, oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt His name together. I sought the Lord and He heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. They looked unto Him and were enlightened, and their faces were not ashamed. One more passage that I want us to look at, beloved. Psalm 37. Psalm 37. I will read from verse 3. Trust in the Lord and do good. So shall thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and shall give thee the desires of thy heart. Commit thy way unto the Lord. Trust also in Him, and He shall bring it to pass. Beloved, and speaking of what I call, we have not passed this way before. We have not passed this way before. If you are alive to hear this message, you and I owe God a lot of thanksgiving and appreciation. For you and I to survive 2020, it is not by our power, it is not by our wisdom. Beloved, we need to thank God for His grace and His mercies upon our lives. If you are alive to see the end of the year 2020, please, you need to be giving thanks unto God now, who has shown your life and your family mercy. In love, the year 2020 happened to be the year of COVID-19. In love, all that happened in that year 2020 has proved that God is greater than everybody. Beloved, year 2020 has proved to us that we are in the last days. That he has shown us that only God knows tomorrow. It says here, the Lord, when the predictions of man about what was going to happen did not come to be. But can I shock you, beloved? The promises that God made to his own children, they were fulfilled in the year 2020. Despite the pandemic. Beloved, there are still children of God in our generation. And God speaks to his own children. All the promises that God made to his own people. The Lord, the pandemic was not able to overcome it. The Lord God still speaks to his own children. As we move into the year 2021, I want to point your attention to Deuteronomy 29, verse 39. Deuteronomy 29, verse 39. We say the secret things belong unto our God. But those things which are revealed belong unto us and to our children forever. That we may do all the works of the law. Beloved, I tell you, only God knows what will happen in the year 2021. But if you are a child of God, God can speak to you and tell you his own plan for the year 2021. Beloved, for the church of God, let me tell you, God has plan for his church in the year 2021. So beloved, what I'm telling you today is this, that even as we are starting a new year, God wants to speak to you. God wants to tell you his plan for your life in this new year. Lord, I want you to listen to the Holy Spirit of God as God directs this message unto you. Please, for those of us who are God's children, I have a message from the Lord unto our lives. Beloved, the message of God to us in year 2021 is that for the world, the year 2021 may not be different from the year 2020. But for those who are God's own children, God cares for their lives. Beloved, God is still the Almighty God for his own children. Beloved, in the year 2021, for those who do not know God, there will be continuation of the wickedness of man to man. The kingdom of darkness will still continue to want to take over the affairs of the world. Let me tell you, as prophesied in the Bible, for the end times, wickedness is still reign, as prophesied in the word of God. Beloved, expect the government to fail. Expect money to fail man. The only thing that will not fail us in the attached one is God Almighty. I pray for you and I that as we are moving into this year 2021, you will hold on to God. Please, if you are a child of God, let me tell you, no matter what is going to happen in the world, God shall be mighty over your life. If you are a child of God, beloved, in the year 2021, God is going to show a demarcation between those who are truly serving God and those who do not know him. We are going to hear where it pays for you to be a child of God. The world will know those who are serving God. Can I also shock you? worship the Lord, as you go into the year 2021, it's going to be a year of judgment. Judgment of the wicked. And judgment of churches who claim to be church of God, despite the fact that they are churches of the devil. So it's going to be a year that will be too dangerous to operate with the power of darkness. And that's why the Lord, this year 2021, for those of us who are children of God, and especially for members of the Divine Islamic Church, it is our year of a closer walk with God. Every one of us, we are going to have personal close relationship with God. So as we are going into this year, the message of God to you, for you to benefit from the plan of God for his own children, decide from this beginning to have a closer walk with God. So year 2021 is our year of closer walk with God. What are the Bible passages supporting this challenge to our lives? Genesis chapter 5, verse 22. Genesis chapter 5, verse 22. It says, and Enoch walked with God after he begat Methuselah 300 years and begat sons and daughters. Beloved, the fact that it's on record that a man called Enoch walked with God, it should be an encouragement to you and I that we too can walk with God. So, beloved, this year 2021, decide to have a closer walk with God. Exodus 33, verse 14. Exodus chapter 33, verse 14. And he said, my presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. Child of God, listen to me at this time. Do not be afraid of the year 2021. Because the word of God to your life is that God's presence will go with you. And because God will be with you, God will give you rest. It does not matter what the whole world is saying. You, as a child of God, claim this personal promise of your Father. Our Heavenly Father is assuring us that as we go into year 2021, his presence will go with us. I pray for everyone, listen to me. Let the presence of God come upon you now. Love Psalm 84, verse 11. Psalm 84, verse 11. Say, for the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from them that walk upright. The Lord, let me tell you, if you are going to walk closely with God, no good thing will help from you. So, if there is a time to walk closely with God, it is in this year 2021 when others will be shouting, crying. But for you as a child of God, because you are walking closely with God, God says, no good thing will he withdraw from you. Finally, I want you to open your Bibles with me to Deuteronomy Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 6. Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 6 is a divine instruction to all of us. Therefore, thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy God to walk in his ways and to fear him. Therefore, you shall keep the commandment of the Lord thy God to walk in his ways and to fear him. Beloved, this is divine expectation of God upon your life and my life. As we are moving into this year 2021, God wants you and I to keep his commandments, to walk in his way, and to fear him. Finally, beloved, what should you and I do to have a closer walk with God in year 2021? I'm going to share with us 4 things that you and I can do to be able to walk with God like Enoch in year 2021. Number one, may the Almighty God, your God, may God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of your life, if you are listening to me and you have not surrendered your life to Jesus Christ, you better do it now. Because without surrendering your life to Jesus, you cannot walk with God. If you are listening to me now and you've been consulting some satanic altars of hell, or you possess some satanic materials in your house, break your life away from them, because they cannot help you in year 2021. So the first thing you and I must do is to make God Almighty your God. Number two thing that you and I should do, beloved, to be able to have a closer walk with God in year 2021, is something you will find in Psalm 37. Psalm 37, verse 5. Psalm 37, verse 5. It says, commit thy way unto the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. You know, I want you to make up your mind now that every day before you leave your house, commit yourself unto God Almighty. Not just go out as somebody that does not have God. Beloved, commit your life unto God, your ways unto God. That is exactly what a man called Jotham did in 2 Chronicles chapter 27. 2 Chronicles chapter 27, verse 6. It says, so Jotham became mighty because he prepared his way before the Lord his God. Lord, you will become mighty in year 2021 if you know how to, on a daily basis, prepare your way before the Lord. Commit your way unto the Lord. Number three thing that you and I need to do to have a closer walk with God: live a deliberate life of holiness and the fear of God. Live a deliberate life of holiness and the fear of God. Beloved, those who will walk with God, they will live holy lives like God Almighty. For you to be qualified to walk with God, you need to fear God. And you will fear God the Lord, by running away from sin, running away from anything that is evil, and anything that is of wickedness. I pray for you and I, that grace to be holy unto God, that grace to live every day of 2021 in fear of God. Receive that grace today in the name of Jesus. Number four thing that you and I need to do to have a closer walk with God. Live a disciplined life of daily meditation in the Word of God. And having daily quiet time with God alone. The Lord, your Christian life will not be the same again. If you can decide that you'll be disciplined to meditate on at least 7 chapters of the Bible every day, the Lord, you will not remain a weak Christian again. If you know how to, on a daily basis, have pastor time alone with God Almighty. A time when you read the Bible, a time when you pray, a time when you remain quiet to hear from God. These are the things that will make your life to be different from that of the world. Beloved, do you want to walk with God in 2021? Number five thing that you need to do, learn how to regularly listen to the voice of God and obey the voice of God. Beloved, there will be dangers all over, but your God will tell you where to go out and where not to go out. There will be kidnappers operating freely in such a country that appears to have no government. But if you're a child of God, the voice of God will tell you what lies ahead. Please, as a child of God, if there's a time you and I need to befriend the Holy Spirit, it is such a year that you are going to. So decide not to be moved by what is happening around you. Just commit yourself to hearing the voice of God. To walk with God in the year 2021. Number 16 that you need to do, beloved, is to learn how to claim your divine rights or benefit in Christ. Beloved, as we are going into this year, there are some divine entitlements that will come to your life if you are working with God. You can enjoy divine health. You can enjoy divine provision. You can enjoy the supernatural protection. You can enjoy divine guidance. You can walk under divine insurance. You know, these are rights and entitlements that God has made available to His own children. You can claim this in your own life through prayer. And this leads me to the final thing that I'm going to ask us to do. To have a closer walk with God in year 2021. Beloved, as you go into this year 2021, live a life full of prayer. Beloved, we need to be prayerful. Let us live a life of prayer. Hear me very well. Our God is alive. Answer prayers. Thank God that I can hear this early today. In order to start this year, I will want us to pray some destiny prayers into our life. So wherever you are, I want to join me as you pray this prayer. The first prayer you will pray is this. Oh God, as I move into this new year, help me to have a closer walk with you. Oh God, as I move into this new year, help me to have a closer walk with you. Wherever you are, I want to pray this in your own life. Oh God, my Father, as I move into this new year, help me to have a closer walk with you. I want to have a closer walk with you. Help me to have a closer walk with you. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, as I move into this new year, help me to have a closer walk with you. In Jesus' mighty name of
prayer.
Beloved, thank God we are at the beginning of a new year. Whatever you ask now, there is a God who will answer you. You will pray again like this. Almighty God, throughout this new year, let your presence be with me. In the name of Jesus, Almighty God, throughout this new year, let your presence be with me. Let your presence be with me. Let your presence be with me. In the name of Jesus, Almighty God, throughout this new year, let your presence be with me. In Jesus' name, amen. The top prayer I want to pray is this. Say, Almighty God, I am depending on you. Keep me by your mighty power throughout this new year. In the name of Jesus, Almighty God, I am depending on you throughout this new year, 2021. Keep me by your mighty power. Keep me by your mighty power. Almighty God, I am depending on you. Keep me throughout this new year. Keep me throughout this new year. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Beloved, the fourth prayer I want to pray today is this. Any evil, any wickedness, any tragedy programmed into this new year, any evil, any wickedness, any tragedy programmed into this new year, fail over my life, fail over my family, fail over my children, fail over my spouse, any evil, any wickedness, any tragedy programmed into this new year, fail family. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Please pray again. Say, oh God, throughout this new year, help me to be connected to you. In the name of Jesus, oh God, throughout this new year, help me to be connected to you. Let nothing break me away from you. Help me, oh God, to be connected to you. Throughout this new year, help me to be connected to you. Help me to be connected to you. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. You will pray again. Oh God, as I move into this new year, teach me the way I should go. In the name of Jesus, oh God, my Father, as I move into this new year, teach me in the way I should go. Teach me in the way I should go. Oh God, as I move into this new year, teach me in the way I should go. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Beloved, this is the final prayer. And I want to prophesy to this new year. Say, I prophesy to this new year. I shall be blessing you. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy to this new year by the power of God. I shall be blessing you. I shall be promoted in you. I shall be blessing you. In this new year, I shall be blessed. I shall be promoted. I shall be honored. In this new year, my throne.
Amen.
Beloved, Happy New Year once again. Beloved, this is our year of a closer walk with God. As we walk closer with God, it shall be well with you. God bless you. Let's give God 7 thanksgiving. Hallelujah. Let's go. Hallelujah. 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 God bless you.